Good morning, class. Today you will do book exercise chapter 3, more on tux paint. Okay, so I'll be sharing the screen also in between sometimes, wherever needed. We'll begin with MCQ part. Okay, so 4 options are there for each question. Out of 4, 1 is the right answer. Sometimes 2 answers are also correct. Okay, so we'll begin with first one. Number 1, which of the following tools would you use to display the images created in TuxPaint in a sequence similar to a presentation? If you know the answer, raise your hand. I'll come to you. Siddha, can you answer? Try, beta. Give a try. Unmute yourself and then answer. Yes, beta.
I've not heard about it, so I'm trying to understand.
Shajit, can you answer? Unmute and answer, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, give a try, beta. At least try. They are asking you, which of the following tools would you use to display the images? Display the images. They have just changed the sentence. It's like a slideshow. We prepare a slideshow. So where we go? We go to open tool. From where we select different slides. I'll show you once. Let me share the screen. Don't get confused. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Are you able to see, beta?
Yes.
Huh?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Now?
Yes, ma'am.
TuxPaint, are you able to see?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Huh. Now see, from here I will show you. They are saying, which of the following tools would you use to display the images created in TuxPaint in a sequence similar to a presentation? So what we do in presentation, we add different slides. Okay, so
yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Open here, I click. Okay, and you can see different slides are there. So I select different slides, and then I can prepare a slideshow from these slides. Okay, so where you have gone? You have gone to open slide. Open tool. That's why the answer is open tool. Okay? Got it?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Huh. Yes, ma'am.
So answer number 1 is open tool.
Open tool.
Open tool. Okay? Now moving on to next. Amar wants to create a scene depicting a hot summer day. Which of the following effects would you use in his drawing? For this also, again, I'll take you back in TuxPaint. Okay? So, let me share the screen, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you able to see?
Yes, ma'am.
Again, TuxPaint. Let me move out of this.
Yes,
ma'am. 1 second, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm back here. Fine. Now blank background is there. Okay. Now we'll use the lighten.
Yes,
they have written 4 options: lighten effect, darken effect, light effect, and snowball. Okay. So we'll first click on magic, and we will see here. Okay. Now 2 options are there together: light and lighten. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll select the lighten. option A is lighten. Okay, so what happens as I select this? It is making the picture light in color. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
What you see on a summer day? Brightness, more brightness, na?
Yes, ma'am.
So
yes,
option ma'am. A is the correct answer. If I take light, light with light, see what is happening. You can just give the effect of light. If it is lightning, thunder, if a bulb is glowing and you want to just show, for that you can use this light, not for summer day. Okay, clear to everyone?
Yes,
so option A is the correct answer, beta. Okay, now moving on to third one. Ritika wants to increase the timing of a slideshow in Tux Paint. Which of the following statement is true? Option A, she can do it by using the sliding scale beside the play button. She cannot speed up the slideshow. I'll just explain you the B part first. She cannot speed up the slideshow, beta. Every time, whether you are working with PowerPoint or Tux Paint or whatever, the timing you can change. Even the screensaver, even the timing of screensaver, if you have selected more than two slides, then you can keep on changing the timing between the two slides. Okay?
Yes.
So second is not correct. Third one, she can do it by using the magic effect. With magic effect, you cannot change the timing. Okay? So the option A is correct. Which is the correct one? Option A is correct. She can do it by using the sliding scale beside the play button. Okay. Moving on to fourth one. Which of the following statement is /R true about the eraser tool and the erase button in the open tool? Now here, beta, many children, they make mistake between erase and eraser. In your Tux Paint, when you open, with the help of which you erase the things. Okay. Now let me tell you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll just take you here. Let me share Tux Paint again. Now I have left the things, whatever was there, like that only. I will go to this button. It is written eraser. If you can see, it is not erase, it is eraser. So as I select this, I am able to erase, okay, whatever part I want. So the eraser tool is used to erase a portion of a drawing is the correct answer. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Now moving on to fill in the blanks. Number one, the dash tool can be used to draw different closed figures. Closed figures, beta, are the shapes. Okay, closed figures are the shapes. First, let me select the new background. Okay, I'll just take white and then open. Fine. So I've selected white. Fine. The dash tool can be used to draw different closed figures. For this, we will move to shapes. Okay, these are the closed figures. If I make a square here, and fine, in any shape I can keep. And whatever color I want, I can select, and with the help of fill, I can fill the color. Okay, these are the closed figures. Okay, so where I have moved first? Shapes. So your first answer is shapes. The shape tool. Okay, you will write,
yes,
the shapes tool can be used to draw different closed figures. Got it? Similarly, second one, the dash tool can be used to insert different image effect. Whatever image, I have first made an image, just take it as an image. Now, to give effect, whenever you want to give effect to a picture, you will move to magic. Got it?
Clear? Yes, ma'am.
So I will select one effect from here. And then I'll just, one effect is there, na, blind effect. And one is magnifying. Blind though we have used, Now this time we'll use magnifying. Let me just find out where magnifying is. Please wait.
Yes, ma'am.
With the help of magnifying, you will be able to make the image. I think it's not magnifying, it is zoom. Let me find it out, okay? Here it is, zoom option, okay? Now, if I'll just try this, now see, are you able to see? It is magnifying. Yes, it is making the squares bigger. As I keep on moving, it becomes smaller and it becomes bigger also. Got it?
Yes,
clear, everyone? Fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Similarly, one option is there, flip. One option is there,
flip.
Let me show you. Here it is. Now, this square is here. Fine? If I'll use this effect, if I'll use this effect, first I'll you see what happens. Okay? Flip means first it was here, now it is here. If in place of this square, I have an elephant picture. So what will be the flip side of an elephant? Suppose his legs are downwards. So with the help of flip, the legs will be upward and the body will be downward. Okay, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is,
yes, ma'am.
The dash tool can be used to insert a heading of a story. Suppose I need to write a heading here. Okay, let me move to first here. I have to write heading here. Where I will go? I will go to text or labels. Got it? So either text or labels. Label also, with the label I can select any text and then I can write here. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay? So like this. So the answer is text and labels. Now next comes, the dash tool can be used to insert words. Text is what, beta? Text is words, that's extra only. Okay? So for words also you will use text only. Whatever words you want to write, you can make use of text. Then they are asking you in the fourth one, the dash tool can be used to insert the picture of a ship or an aeroplane. Okay, any picture if you want to insert. Let me stop sharing the screen first. Now number four, they are asking, the dash tool can be used to insert the picture of a ship or an aeroplane. In the beginning of the chapter, when I have shared a picture of penguin, I have shared,
yes,
so what tool was used?
Yes, ma'am.
The stamp tool. Which stamp tool I have used? Stamp tool.
Stamp tool.
So your answer will be stamp tool. S-T-A-M-P. Stamp. Now moving on to true and false. Number one, a storyboard consists of slides that are displayed in a sequence. It is true. A slideshow depicts a story consisting of many slides. Again, it is true. To create a tree, we can use the magic tool. Yes, of course, we can create a tree. Okay. Then last one, the smudge effect can be used to create clouds. Now, I'll show you what is smudge effect. Let me share the screen with you. Now, look here, my dear children. Smudge effect is in magic tool. Okay. From magic tool, I need to select smudge. Smudge effect. Okay. So let me first move to smudge effect. Here it is. Okay. So as I'll click here, now wherever I will move the magic brush, you see what is happening. What is given in the
yes,
question? You can create a cloud. Are we able to create a cloud? No, it is not a cloud.
No,
we are just able to smudge. Okay? The sides, etc.
Yes.
It is not making a proper cloud. Okay? Clear?
Yes,
so
yes,
it is false. Number four is false.
False.
Hope you have understood, beta.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
that's why we have done it practically also. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Good children.